Welcome to the Glenn Beck Program. Reading through the news of the day, and more of it is starting to sound like characters from Charlie Brown. You know what I mean? All you hear is mumbling. Nothing seems to be changing. The border, the news today, 72 Central and South American migrants on a ranch just south of the U.S. border killed. How about individual liberties? The Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals says now the government can trespass on your property to place a tracking device on your car without a warrant and track your comings and goings. Joe Biden is out campaigning about the wonders of the Recovery Act and is excited to spend more taxpayer money that we don't have. There's a new poll out that shows voters now trust Republicans on more than all the 10 key issues. You got to be kidding me, really? Why? When has switching the R and the D ever changed a darn thing? That is not the answer, gang. Tonight, I'll show you what I believe the answer is. Come on, we got work to do. Hello, America. I saw the headline today on the Drudge Report, and the reality of the weekend kind of hit me upside the head. Could you show that? Yeah. That's not good. Sharpton looms. Is it too late to cancel Al? I know Al Sharpton. I strangely like him, and we get along. Al, God bless you. God bless you. And I wish you well this Saturday, and I mean that, my friend. It is hard to believe that in about 40 hours, we will all be gathering together at the steps of the Lincoln Memorial. I was down at the site earlier today. In fact, I was there, I think, about 6:30 this morning, and then again around noon, watching everything come together. It is amazing to see, just walking around the grounds. Last night, I was there about midnight. We had some things that had to be changed, and I was there, and people started to gather, and they were from Michigan, and they were from California. People, midnight last night, people just got off the plane and wanted to come see the grounds. It is one of the most beautiful places, I think, in America. I used to sit in the morning when I lived here in Washington about three columns in and watch the sunrise. It is spectacular because it rises right over the Capitol. It is a miracle. And the weather this Saturday is also a miracle. It's supposed to be perfect. In August, in Washington, D.C., this is a swamp. It is supposed to be 82 and low humidity and perfect sunshine. I mean, thank you. Thank you. The Lincoln Memorial, the reflecting pool, if you haven't been here and seen the new World War II monument, it is remarkable. Bring your children to see the Washington Monument. It's looming in the distance. If they're not watching, ask them this. You'll see that up about a quarter of the way, the stone changes colors. Nobody knows this. Ask them why it's a different color. Do you know? That's where they stopped building it during the Civil War. It's pretty amazing to see the history. For me, it was quite humbling to stand as I'm walking up the stairs, and you'll see it right in the center, the one flight down from Abe Lincoln. You will see, carved in stone, usually people pour water on it so you can see it. It just says, Dr. Martin Luther King, I have a dream. It's right there that Martin Luther King stood and delivered his I have a dream speech. For me, that was a little humbling because I'm not going to be standing there. I'm way down the stairs from there. But what that man did and what he went through and the people that came and what they went through to come. I've read the papers from the day before his speech, and it was incredible what they said. This guy is still, he hasn't been carved in stone yet, so to me at least, he's more of a man and less than a monument, and maybe that's why I can relate to him a little bit more than giant Abraham Lincoln. But it is impossible to look around in that area and not be overwhelmed by the sense of history of it all. And when I say history, I mean the history of America. Our first president, not carved in stone, he would have hated that, just tall, straight and erect, Abraham Lincoln. The greatest generation at the end of the reflecting pool. Martin Luther King, being around all of these things in that small, sacred space is pretty overwhelming. The memorials to some of the most honorable people in our nation's history is inspiring enough, so you can only imagine. I think I can imagine. I think it's going to be a little overwhelming as we see, I don't know, tens of thousands of people standing together, shoulder to shoulder, locked arm in arm, peaceful, happy, in disagreement on some things, in agreement on others. Thousands and thousands of regular citizens who have come as far as Europe. One, I got a letter from somebody who's coming with their wife from Nigeria, just to experience it. People who will not only recognize heroes, this is one of the awards we're giving away, three awards to citizens. It is based on the merit badge, the Purple Heart from George Washington. This, we're giving three away. I haven't seen any speculation on who these three that are going to win, what citizens deserve this merit for faith, hope, and charity. People will gather and see this, and hopefully we will mutually pledge to each other our lives, our fortunes, and our sacred honor. At least we will begin to look at those things, start to maybe challenge that we haven't valued those things high enough. Honesty, integrity, merit, personal responsibility, family, and God. That is why we call it the Restoring Honor event. Chris Wallace just talked to me in his office a few minutes ago. I'm going to be doing an interview with him right after the event for Fox News Sunday. It's the only interview I will be doing. And he asked me, why is it called Restoring Honor? Well, it's not a political event, because I haven't found a lot of honor when it's followed by an R or a D. Principles and values that should be universal, but I think in most cases now it seems in our country they are non-existent. I've been examining the problems of this country and I've been trying to come up with ways out. We're entering the last exit. Last exit. We need to get off this highway. I was leaving the memorial site today and a reporter jumped out at me. I was trying to run because I was late for work and I was running to my car and this reporter jumped out and she said, I'm so-and-so from ABC. And I said, hey. And she said, this is her question. What do you expect to gain from this event? I don't even know what that means. Do you? I mean, I know what I have to lose. What do I have to gain? ABC is not alone. Most of the reports seem to completely miss the mark of what I've named it. Honor. Restoring honor. How merit. I mean, how much more obvious? How are you missing this? Merit. Honor. The Washington Post had a story today, which actually, I mean, I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe that I actually read the Washington Post, but then I couldn't believe that that was actually pretty fair, all things considered. But they talked about the implications this event will have on the future of tea parties. I couldn't figure that one out. I read it to my wife in bed last night. How exactly does this measure the strength or weakness of the tea party? In the story, they talked about how the GOP is distancing themselves from this event. To distance themselves would imply that at some point they were close to the event. I've also heard that this event is all about the elections coming November. Let me just say this. If you are planning to drive here from, I don't care if it's across the street or 1,000 miles, to hold up a campaign slogan sign, go home. Save your time. First of all, no signs. Don't bring your signs. Bring your hearts. Bring your open minds. That's it. Bring your kids. Your kids are important. If you bring a sign, you're going to be disappointed. No signs. I've also heard people wondering about how big or small the crowd size will be. I've heard people speculate that what's going to happen? What is Glenn Beck going to do after the event? NPR wrote about the event today, wondering what stunt is Glenn Beck going to pull, noting that progressive pundits are expecting me to pervert the memory of Martin Luther King, and that I don't have the credentials to speak at the location of MLK's speech. Oh my gosh. And then there was this. Attendees are prohibited from bringing signs. The fear, of course, is that it will turn into a pit of hatred, a la the healthcare town halls. A pit of hatred? A pit of hatred. written with our taxpayer dollars. See, this is where I get confused about people saying that I don't have the credentials to speak about honor and integrity and about the judging people by the content of their character, when the very same people that are saying that about me seem awfully quick to cast an entire group of individuals into a pit of hatred just because they disagree with a particular policy. I've heard it over and over again in the media that because of this event, on the date of this event, I'm somehow or another hijacking Dr. Martin Luther King's speech. I'm not big enough to do that. No one is. I had no idea August 28th was the day of the MLK speech when we booked it. I knew that MLK spoke at the Lincoln Memorial. I knew that it was about the content of character. I knew it was about civil rights and injustice. I knew all of those things, but I'm sorry, media, that I forgot the oh-so-important detail of the date. That is the problem with our country. When you go to school, you ask your kids, all they care about is the date. It's not the date, it's the message. The point is, as you can see, not many people are focused on the actual message of any given thing at all, let alone this event. Again, we're arguing about the date. At best, they're operating in the same old political boxes they usually operate out of. Glenn Beck, bad. Sarah Palin, bad. Must destroy. Have you heard the media even talk about the idea of honor? Why? How about this question? Why would Glenn Beck say honor is missing? Why would Glenn Beck say the answer is God? What's happening with our religions? Would anybody cover that? No. Have you heard anybody mention the troops? Has anybody mentioned who could possibly deserve an award for merit? Who have done things that hurt them personally or cause great sacrifice? Has anybody called the Special Operations Warrior Foundation. I had them on the show last night. These are amazing people. Has the media bothered to interview one person involved with SOWF except for saying, how is Glenn Beck getting rich off of this? Then they say the event is shrouded in mystery. It is not if you don't have an agenda. Take a look at any one of our men and women in the amazing military that we have and say, gee, why would Glenn Beck want to put them in a spotlight? Here's your answer. Honor. We have a shortage of people like these guys. That's the problem in our country. We have a shortage of character. We don't even know how to teach it to our children anymore. We're running low on personal responsibility. We've got a loss of integrity, a loss of shame in this country, a loss of principles and values. We've lost our way because we have lost God. If you want to restore America, you go ahead and do it with your little party thing. I don't think that's going to work. We've lost our honor. We must restore our honor first, our principles. Saturday's message, shh, it's a big secret. I've only talked about it for 6 months on one of the biggest cable news shows in history and the third largest radio show in America, but only 6 months, so shh, keep it down, just between us. Don't tell anyone in the media. The secret is God. I've told you how many times that I stood on the steps where Martin Luther King stood. The media is, who does he think he is? When I first stepped down those steps, maybe 3 or 5 months ago, I stood in that spot, and that is exactly what I thought. Who the hell do you think you are? A nobody, a citizen, a man of faith, a dad. A guy who truly believes that our country is in trouble. And I am willing to do and say the hard things. I am willing to lose my life, my fortune, but not my sacred honor. I have lost it before because of the things that I have done in my past. I'm a recovering alcoholic. It's the only thing that is truly yours, your name and your honor. I will not lose that.